Down over me. Yeah, I got a friend. Talk to you about your car's extended warranty. Just kidding. Where was I? I lost my train of thought.
Dollywood.
Dollywood? I don't think that's how the song goes. I think it's more like
Memphis.
Boy, you got a prayer in Memphis.
Thank you.
single girl. Oh. Whoa. We didn't have to say that part.
All right, let's take it back to the 80s. See if y'all remember this one. To answer that question is with music, because music is a huge part of our lives. It has been around us ever since I can remember. My parents, they would always sing together, and one night in particular, they were sitting in our living room, and my dad had his acoustic guitar in his hands, and my mom was sitting next to him, and they were just singing just random songs and singing harmonies with each other, and us four kids walked in the room one by one and started adding harmonies to the songs they were singing. We weren't thinking about it, we were just adding harmonies. And they stopped us and they were like, hold on, y'all can hear harmony? And we were like, well, I guess we can. And so because of that, we learned a good handful of songs just for fun, and we would sit down in our living room and sing them together. And one day we thought, we need a test audience to try these songs out on and see how we sound. And we thought of our grandparents, and for those of y'all who might not know who they are, my grandma, her name is Nora Lee Allen, and she has been singing background vocals at the Grand Ole Opry now for 40 years, over 40 years, actually. How many of y'all been to the Opry before? Have y'all been? Oh, so yeah, a lot of y'all been. It is. Up in Nashville, it is amazing down there. We've been there, grown up there, basically. And that's my grandma. And then my granddad, his name is Dwayne Allen, and he is the lead singer of the Oak Ridge Boys. And have y'all seen the Oaks live? Have any of y'all seen them live before? So some of y'all have, yeah. I see some of y'all in the back, but so those are our grandparents, and we sang for them, and they really encouraged us to keep going at it and keep singing and just do what we love. And so that's exactly what we've been doing now for 13 years, and it has just been so much fun. But we like to have a little part in our shows, kind of taking you guys back in a little time machine and showing you what it was like when we first started singing together in our living room. So we got our stools out here. We're gonna get nice and cozy with you guys. Do y'all want any sweet tea? You got any sweet tea, Meg, in the kitchen, you know? But yes, we're from Nashville, Tennessee. She might have said it earlier. But this is like our backyard, you know? This is not too far from home for us at all. So, we're excited to be here. But with all that being said, let's do
take it back to how we started. We'd be sitting on the couch with Paul on the guitar. That's just singing along, adding some harmonies in. And you know, we always love to find family bands, because there's something about family harmony. If anybody has sung with their family, you know, your sibling voices are always very similar, and they lock into place and just kind of breathe. You know what I mean? So here's an example of one of the first songs we learned together.
I was thinking of going way down south for this next one.
Way, way down.
like way down south. I mean like way down south.
Like past Florida?
Like other side of the world down south?
Down
under?
There's a great family group from Australia. And we always love them.
Love their harmonies.
Anybody got an idea what I'm thinking?
Are we talking about the Brothers Gibb?
Brothers Gibb, yeah, that's one.
As in the Bee Gees?
Yep, there you go.
All right.
Christmas song.
Christmas.
do.
You know, maybe the first one.
I know what we do. Hang on. This will work.
I think she might have stumped. You know what? We do know a Dolly song.
We do know another Dolly song.
Oh, okay.
How about we do this one? Okay, it's funny. People were asking us, you know, since y'all are in Dollywood, y'all got to learn at least like one Dolly song. And so literally today, backstage, before the show, we were practicing this song. So hopefully it sounds good. But here you go. Here's a Dolly song we learned.
There it is, it's in the key of D.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Why'd you come in here looking like that? In your cowboy boots and your painted on jeans, all licked out like a cowgirl's dreams. Why'd you come in here looking like that?
Here comes my baby, dragging my heart.
The queen herself.
queen ourselves.
Yes, let's do one more request, and we'll go back to.
Did you say Sublime?
Sublime!
I don't practice it! I don't practice it!
Right here, let me.
Say it again, hold on. Sublime? You want to do Sublime?
No, listen. Hey,
Dumb Blonde by Dolly Parton?
Oh, I don't know that. I don't know that.
No, that's no way to talk about my wife.
Did somebody really say Sublime?
I don't think so. I think we misheard.
You heard it wrong.
Alright, so.
Eagles. Well, I'm running down the road, trying to loosen my load. Got the world in trouble on my mind. I'm gonna hold me up on a stormy one. Says you're a friend of mine. But take it easy, take it easy. Don't let the sound of your own wheels drive you crazy. We may lose and we may win, but we will never be here again. So open up, I'm climbing in. Take it easy.
All right, that's all the party tricks we got. No more.
You guys got to come back. I like playing Stump the Man.
Hey, now.
Hey, we love doing songs with a lot of people. There's a lot of great songs out there. I love to do covers. We love to write songs as well. Being from Nashville, so many great songwriters, and we've done their songs, but you know what? They all write too. And sometimes you got something that nobody else can say it as good as you can. Mark, tell them about a song you've written.
Well, whenever I was a young man,
25 comes.
I know, I got a baby face. when I was younger than I am now, let's put it that way. Thank you, whoever the clapping was from, I appreciate that. Whenever I would come home from school and I had a new crush, somebody I was kind of sweet on, I guess, I would ask my mom, I'd be like, Mama, how do you know when you found the person you're going to spend the rest of your life with? And she would just kind of look at me and she would laugh and just kind of say, you know, son, I don't think you're going to have to ask those kinds of questions when you meet that person. I think it's just kind of going to make sense and I think you'll just know. So with that answer frustrated me, of course, because it wasn't cut and dried black and white to the point, but I took that and wrote a song about it. It's called L-O-A, and I hope you like it.
Sugar took my breath away.
Thank you.
I hope that you have enjoyed your day at Dollywood as much as we have. Go ride some of these awesome roller coasters. Let me tell you, we took a minute and did that, and we had so much fun. Kids, have y'all had a fun day today? Have you had a great time? Well, we're so happy you came to join us here at this
show. Y'all ride Lightning Rod?
I doubt they rode Lightning Rod. But we did, and it was awesome. Oh my goodness. Well, I tell you what, we're loving it here at Harvest Fest. We're so happy you joined us. If you're going to be around the rest of the week or tomorrow or any day, come on back here to the Back Porch Theater and see us again tomorrow. 6:15, 7:45. And we're going to leave you with this.
See you again.